Hi guys, today I am going to be doing a brow tutorial and I'll be showing you how I fill in my eyebrows. I am so excited to do this video because I've been meaning to do it for a little while, but I never felt like I was ready to do it until now because I think I finally found the perfect technique that allows my brows to look as best as they can and, more importantly, it doesn't take me forever to do them. So anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial, but not before I talk about the products that I'm using because I wanted to kind of talk about them before I show you how I use them. So the products I'll be using today, the first one is Anastasia Brow Pomade. I just spent like 5 minutes trying to figure out how to say it. I'm gonna go with Anastasia, but if it's wrong, then do correct me in the comments down below. Anyway, Anastasia Brow Pomade is an amazing product. Ever since I've discovered it, I stuck with it, and I have two colors because I was actually a little bit darker beforehand. Now I'm a little bit blonder, so I picked up a lighter color. But I do want to talk about the colors right after I show you what the pomade looks like. This is an amazing product because it is so workable. You can do a lot with it. You can really fill in your brows and have them look natural and have that definition and be really precise or blend it out. So it's just a really versatile product and it's really easy to use, and I highly recommend it. Even though it's a little bit pricey, it's $18 I believe for a little tub like this, so it's not the cheapest product out there, but it's definitely worth it. So I have two colors here. One matches my roots pretty well and the other one is just a little bit lighter. Now this color is called taupe and this color is called blonde. I prefer to go with a color that's just a tad bit lighter than my brow hairs because that allows the brow hairs to pop through, stand out, and create that texture that looks really, really natural, because otherwise your brow will have no visible hairs and just have one tone. But if you go with a color that matches your brow hairs perfectly, you're still not gonna look weird. It's just, I think, a little bit better to go with a color that's like half a shade lighter. So you can see this color is not too much lighter than my brow hairs, but it's a little bit lighter and it's dark enough to look normal and light enough to allow the hairs to stand out. All right, next let's talk about the brush, because this is another extremely important tool that you're going to be using. So I have the Anastasia angled brow brush, which has the actual brush on one side and then a spoolie on the other. This is an amazing brush. It's nice and thin. It's got the perfect length to it. It's got the perfect angle to it, and it's got a really nicely sized spoolie, which is actually a lot smaller than most spoolies that I found. It's just so perfectly designed, so I highly recommend it. But if you don't want to spend the $18, there are a lot of angled brushes out there that you can buy, but you do need an angled brush and a spoolie, even if it's not this exact brush. All right, next you're going to need a concealer and a concealer brush. This is going to be an optional product that you'll be using, but I highly recommend it if you want to create that highly defined underbrow arch. So the concealer that I'll be using today is Maybelline Super Stay Better Skin. This is a great concealer, but you don't have to use this exact concealer. I did a review on this concealer and I will leave that down below. And I'll also be using a more smaller shade brush as well to go along with the concealer. This is just a flat domed brush that I think is really, really handy to use for concealing their underbrow area. But again, you don't have to use this exact brush. You can use whatever you have. So anyway, that is that for the products that I'll be using. Again, you don't have to use these exact products, but if you do want to use these products, I think they're great products and they work really, really well. And before we go into the next section, I do want to ask you to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of my videos, and like this video if you do like this video. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the next section where I'll be showing you how I fill in my eyebrows. First, I begin lining the bottom part of the brow, starting with the outer third and then working my way towards the inner part of the brow. The reason I like to work on the outer part of the brow is that it's a lot harder to mess up the outer part of the brow and a lot easier to mess up the inner part of the brow. It's a lot easier to overfill it and just make it look really unnatural. So I always start with the outer part, and then as I get more comfortable and I know what I'm doing with that portion of the brow, I slowly work my way towards the inner part of the brow. When I get to the inner part of the brow right here, I actually like to bring that line just a little bit further than where my brow actually begins. This makes the brow seem a little bit longer. So now that the first step is done, the second step is to line the top of the brow. I start to line my brows where my hairs on top start to grow
grow horizontally instead of vertically. So that would be about 1/4 of the way in, as you can see from the video. And then once you're done with that, go ahead and start filling the gap in between the two lines. With my brush strokes, I like to mimic how my brow hairs are growing. So if they are horizontal, my brush strokes are going to be horizontal. And if they're growing vertical, like they are towards the inner part of the brow, my brush strokes are going to mimic that as well. Next, we're going to take a spoolie and just run it through the brows to smooth any harsh lines and make everything seem more natural. This is what the brow filling looks like before we go ahead and apply some concealer. Take your favorite concealer and a small flat brush and line the bottom of your brow with the concealer. And then go ahead and fade that line out with your finger to make everything look seamless and smooth. This is an optional step, but I highly recommend taking it because this adds an extra bit of definition to your underbrow area and just makes everything look really, really nice, sharp, defined, and gorgeous.
So that is it for my video. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave those in the comment section below. I love reading comments. You guys are awesome. Thank you for any of you who subscribe to my channel. You guys are really, really awesome. And I will see you in the next video and have an awesome day. Bye.